So for this question, I'm going to apply the excess and shortage concept, right? I'm going to write the concept name here, excess and shortage concept. All right, what is excess and shortage concept? It is a question where you will have, first and foremost, you're going to have two ifs. One if and two if. Can you see the two ifs there? Okay, so this is my first if. And then this is my second if. Let's look at the first if sentence. So if she bought 5 balls, she would have $5.80 left. Can you see the word left there? Okay. The word left tells me that this is in excess. Means there's a lot more extra. Okay. She has extra money of $5.80. So if it is excess, then we will put it as plus, means you got extra money. Okay. Now let's look at the second if. If she bought 8 balls, she would need another $2.60. So if she have bought 8 balls, she need another. Need another means not enough. Not enough. All right. So this is in shortage. So if it's a shortage, we put it as minus $2.60. Okay. Then I want to know how much money did she have at first. All right. So we have all this information. Then what are we going to do? I am going to draw out the box, the excess and shortage box. Okay. So this is how it looks like. No copying. And then we cut it up into 3 columns. So 1, 2, 3. Okay. So this one will be my if. This is excess or shortage. This will be my total. I have my first if and my second if. Then we draw a line across. Okay. Then we put in all the information based on what we have underlined from the keyword. Okay, so the first if, where do I get my first if? The if here will be representing units, but I don't have units, right? Where will the unit comes from? I will represent the number of balls as units. The number of balls as units. So in this first if, she bought 5 units of the balls. Okay, and then she have excess of $5.80. So that will be plus 580. All right, then the second if, she bought 8 balls. So 8 balls means 8 units of balls. And then she need another $2.60, which is minus $2.60, like that. Okay, how do I get my total? Easy, just look row wise. Row number 1, just copy down 5 unit plus 580. Row number 2, 8 unit minus 260. Okay, since these two, they are talking about the same amount of money, the sum money, right? She brought some money to the toy shop. And these two total, this total and this total are talking about the same amount of money. It's a matter of whether she wants to buy 5 balls or whether she wants to buy 8 balls. She haven't buy it yet. If, the word is if she buy 5 balls, she need 580 left. If she buy 8 balls, she need another 260, which means these two total that I have here are referring to the same amount of total money. So this is the same. So if it's the same, we can put it as a number statement. So it will look like this. Okay. And then equals to 8 unit minus 260. All right. So we are going to group up all the units to one side. Units to one side. So it will look like this. Equals to 8 unit minus 5 units, and then put all the numbers to another side. Okay, so we're going to put all the numbers, $5.80 plus 260. Okay, so this 260 goes over to the other side. When it goes over the equal sign, it becomes opposite. That's why you can see it becomes plus. All right, so what will this be? It will be 3 units is 840. So if you're more comfortable with it, flip, then you flip it. 3 units is 840. 1 unit is 840 divided by 3, and I get $2.80. Okay. Now, how much money does she have at first? So you can either look at this one or this one. I want to use this to find my answer because it's easier. It's just 5 units plus 580. You sum as minus. Okay. I use the plus instead of minus. So since I know what is 1 unit, 1 unit is 280. Now I want to know 5 units, right? So 5 units plus 580 is equals to 5 unit means 5 times 280 bracket plus 580 equals to $19.80. So how much money did she bring at first? $19.80. Okay, so this is excess and shortage concept.